Hi, I'm Aaliyah. I'm a New York chef who's passionate about exotic spices, traditions, and places. Welcome to my exotic table.
As a cook, I love coming up with fun dishes for the home, and traveling is the best inspiration. A recent trip to Goa was incredibly rich, and I explored it all. From villages to beaches, Portuguese architecture and culinary influences, and the bustling outdoor markets. I learned from the locals everywhere I went, in their homes, working in restaurants, and my first stop, a spice farm called Savoy.
So this plantation is more than 200 years old, and this is all organic. We don't use any chemical fertilizers. Different spices are used. What we grow is cinnamon, cardamom, cloves, black pepper, ginger, turmeric. This is the working farm. In the sense, whatever we harvest, we sell it to the cooperative. And from the cooperative, some spices are exported, not all. So to export, only the very good, first quality spices are exported.
Okay. Very nice. And you also have medicinal spices as well.
We got a lot of medicinal properties of different spices. The much important is cinnamon, neem oils.
What does neem do?
Neem is so bitter, the leaves of neem. And the leaves of the neem tree and the fruit, berries, we use to store our food grain like rice, barley, lentil and all. Otherwise we have to use, when we store rice at one small drum, all the insect will come. If you put these leaves, it won't
attack.
So this is a natural way of making protection.
Okay.
After my briefing on the workings of the farm, I toured the grounds with Joseph, one of the experts there.
So for the curry, you cannot use vinegar. You can use vinegar, fish curry rice.
It doesn't taste that good.
Yeah, that's good. So that's why they start putting, because it was tasting a sour and sweet. So that's why they start putting the kokum.
Kokum and tamarind are used as souring agents in a lot of the dishes of the region. I spent some time in a culinary school there where I learned so much about Goan cuisine and actually got to teach some American dishes to the students as well. The culinary school is part of a 5-star hotel, and the head chef was kind enough to talk to me about differences between the Portuguese Goan and Hindu Goan cuisines.
Here, Goa has a very rich tradition of both the Catholic and as well as Hindu cuisines. The Catholic is more of the coastal side cuisine, where people use a lot of seafood and a lot of ingredients left by the Portuguese. The difference is both cuisine, Hindu and Catholic, both cuisine use a lot of seafood. That one thing is very common. And second thing, they use rice as a staple food. The Catholic cuisine use vinegar as a souring agent. And Catholic, they use a lot of toddy for making items like vindaloo and sanas, those kind of things. Whereas in Hindu cuisine, they don't use toddy for cooking purposes.
And toddy is the local Goan vinegar.
Yeah, it's a toddy. It's a sap taken from coconut tree, which is fermented. And in the Hindu cuisine, they use a lot of spices like cinnamon, cardamom, and cloves, nutmeg, those kind of spices. And for souring, they use kokum. It's a pink color berry which is locally available.
So there are a ton of mussel dishes out there, and I've seen them in different cultural incarnations. You know, you have your French, which is your shallots and white wine. You have a Latin version that has chorizo. You have your Thai green curry mussels. When I was in India, you know, in Goa, the tart, the spicy, the sweet, the salty, as I mentioned before, to me it just lended itself to a mussel dish. I thought it would be wonderful. It was actually this drink I had called solkadi. It's a digestive that's had halfway through the meal. And it's coconut with kokum and cilantro, and I was drinking that and I thought this is the perfect mussel base. So that's how I came up with this recipe. Now to me, the single most important thing about mussels is cleaning them right, because nobody wants to eat sandy, gritty mussels. Then I like to soak them in ice water that has salt in it. Now the other thing is, when you soak them in the salted ice water, it allows them to kind of open up, and some of that residual sand and grit leave. So I'm going to start by chopping my shallots. So while I'm chopping these up, I'm going to turn my pan on. You want about a medium-low heat. You just want to sweat out your shallots slowly. I'm also going to throw in my chilies now, and I'm just going to split them so that no bits come in your mouth. I just want the flavor in there, but without actually having to eat them. This is cinnamon and coriander, and I'm going to add them at this point because I want them to toast up a little bit. So once the shallots are translucent, we can add in the garlic, and the garlic is only going to take 30 seconds, just until it's fragrant. I'm going to use my garlic press because I like when the juices of the garlic get in there. You can hear it when the garlic hit the pot. The sound just picks up. And that's what cooking is all about. It's about using your senses. Yes, your taste, your smell, but also your hearing. You have to listen when you cook. We're gonna add in the white wine. I'm just using a good drinking white wine. How about reducing? I'm gonna grab some cilantro, because I actually want the cilantro to cook in with the sauce and infuse the sauce with its flavor. So this is reducing, and we want it to almost all dry up. Now that the wine is pretty much dried up, we're gonna add in the coconut milk, a little bit of honey for sweetness, and the signature fruit, cocoa. I love it because it has this purple hue, which gives the dish a really pretty flavor. I use somewhere between 1 and 3. I'm gonna go for about 3 right now. So we're almost ready to throw in the mussels. And at the end, I like to throw in more cilantro and green onions. So while this is cooking, I'm gonna chop up a few more green onions. Okay, so the broth is ready, and I'm just gonna taste it to check for seasoning. Let's see. Okay, a little bit of salt, and some fresh black pepper. Okay. Now we're gonna drain the mussels, rinse them, and throw them in. I'm gonna give them a quick stir, cover them up, and let them cook. Now we're gonna cut the bread. I like to use French bread, but you can use any bread that you like. Let's check on our mussels. There they go, they're done. At this point, I'm gonna throw in the cilantro, the green onions, and give it a fresh squeeze of lemon juice. And they look delicious. Get rid of these chilies, and we are ready to roll. I got the mussels, I got the sauce, I got the crusty bread. I'm ready to eat. Excuse me. That coconut brings such creaminess to the dish, but there's still a lot of heat. And the cocoa gives it that tart quality. It really brings me back my trip to Goa. A great inspiration for my exotic table.